Good afternoon. Switch on your cameras.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon. Lena?
Yes, ma'am.
Let's start. So, any doubts in chapter 24? Health and wellness? Okay, so let's move on to the next chapter, that is family income and income management, chapter 25. Chapter 25, family income and income management. Okay. Why we need money, Sana? For what purpose we need money?
Buy things.
To buy things, to buy commodities, then? Meghna? Why we need money? Meghna?
Educational
For
purposes.
education, yes. Then?
Dress for daily basis. And
We
for
can't survive, right? We can't survive without money. Isn't it? We need money. But what is the importance of money? Is it important as food?
yes,
Yes.
without money, we can't buy food.
Yeah, right. So we need money for every task, every activity, we need money. But we must earn money, but we should also enjoy our life. We should also spend time with our family, right? Money is an integral part, but only money, earning money, just earning money, that's not good, right? We need to spend or we need to use that money in a, or use that money wisely. That is the correct method. Then, yeah. So that's all about money. That's a general part. Then, what do you mean by family income? What is family? Family income. Family income. Yeah, one by one.
Which a father earns every
Yeah.
month.
Okay. Meghna?
The income that brought by the family members that live in
Yeah,
one.
that's the right one. Which means the family income means we sum. Sana, please switch on the camera. We have, okay. So family income means we just add the income or wage from every family member, not only from the father. Sometimes women are also working, right? So the wages or salary from the father, from mother, from every family members, we sum this all money together. That is called as family income. Okay. Simple one now. So that is family income. Then there are three classification of family income. It's very important, no doubt. Family income classification. So there are three types of family income. First one, money income. Second, real income and psychic income. Are you familiar with these terms, Meghna?
No, ma'am.
No. Sana? Yeah, fine. So these are the three classification of family income. Family income means it's a sum total of income of all types and form of all sources of all family members in a time period. Sum total of all the money, that is family income. There are three classification: money income, real income, and psychic income. Sana, read. What are the three classification? Learn within the
Money
class.
income, real income, psychic income.
Very good. So first one, money income. Money income. As the name says, this income or this flows into the family in the form of money, in the form of wage, or just in the form of money. like the currency, the coins, the checks from the bank, all these comes under this money income in the form of currency. Okay. This money income that includes our wages. What is the difference between wage and a salary?
Wages daily.
Daily, right.
Salary month or
monthly. Year. Okay, very good. So this money income that includes the salary, wages, and then sometimes we get some amount of money from house rent, right? We give our house for rent, so we get money from that rent, right? Not only the house, but also the land, any property, we get rent. That also comes under the money income, salary, wages, this rents. Okay, so money income means the income flows to the family in the form of money or currency or checks. Okay, then real income. Next one, the second one, that is real income. There are two types of real income. One is direct income and the second one, that is indirect income. Okay, real income classification. This classification of family income is very, very, very important. Sure question. So real income is classified into direct income and indirect income. So first one, that is direct income. Like then the second one, that is real income, the real income classification, that is direct income and indirect income. What do you mean by direct income? First, just note the definition. It consists of those material goods and services. It consists of those material goods and services available to the family members. Available to the family members without the use of money. Without the use of money. Okay. Like, for example, this vegetables and fruits from our own garden. So we can save money. We don't need money to buy or to collect the vegetables and fruits from our own garden, right? We get the goods or we get the services. We don't need money. And then for another example, teaching children, a homemaker can teach their own children. So she can save the money. She don't need money to teach her own children, right? So without the use of money, we also get some amount of goods or some amount of services. That is direct income. Okay, real income is classified into two, direct income and indirect income. Direct income means, what do you mean by direct income? Without the use of money. For example, the vegetables and fruits from our own garden, teaching children. So for all these purposes, we don't need money. Only our knowledge, our interest, our skills. By the proper use of these kind of human resources, we can also save our money, or we don't need money, these kind of resources. Okay. And then the next one, that is indirect income. indirect income. It comes under the real income. Are you familiar with the barter system? Barter system. Yes, what do you mean by barter system? Make them.
If the party want the jackfruit, then she gives her gold bangle to the other party to get that particular jackfruit.
Yeah. If I need a 1 kg of apple, I give anything else other than this thing to another person or the other party, and I collect the thing I want. That is barter system. That comes under this indirect income without the use of money. And sometimes the extra benefits from workplaces. It's another example. In our case, in our school, the accommodation, our food, everything is free in hostel. So it's an additional bonus for the teachers, right? Other than the salary, this free accommodation and free food. So it's easy for the workers or easy for the teachers. In our case, it's an added benefit or an extra benefit or extra bonus for the workers. Free accommodation, free salary and all. That's also a need. Now, so the teachers. What is indirect income? Shana, what is indirect income?
Like barter system.
Okay. The sometimes also the extra benefits or extra bonus from the authority. That also comes under this indirect income. It's also known as real direct income or real indirect income. Okay. The exchange of commodities also known as this barter system. Then the last one, that is psychic income. PSYCHIC. Psychic income. Psychic income means it's a satisfaction or a satisfaction. For an example, if a person eat enough amount of food from a restaurant, he get a satisfaction, right? He give money or he use that money to eat a particular amount of food, then he get a satisfaction. That is psychic income. Okay, you can write the definition. This is a satisfaction which people experience. Psychic income. This is the satisfaction which people experience. It can be the mental satisfaction or it can be the emotional satisfaction. But it is very difficult to estimate or it's very difficult to identify the level of satisfaction everyone gets, right? Our satisfaction is different from other satisfaction. So it is very difficult to identify the amount of satisfaction a person get after eating a particular amount of food. Okay, it's just an example. Okay, so if someone asks, what do you mean by psychic income? It's just a satisfaction income. Okay, is it clear?
So ma'am, what to write indirect income for sentence?
Indirect income. Actually, there is no definition for this indirect income. You can just write this barter system facilities or barter system and the services. There is no definition for that. Okay, so this family income is classified into three: the money income, real income, and psychic income. Money income means income in the form of money, as the name says, money income. Income in the form of money. And this real income is classified into two: real direct income and real indirect income. Real direct income means the facilities and services rendered without spending money. It's in the page number 292. And then Indirect income, that is facilities and services rendered by extra efforts or by spending money. You can write this as a definition. Okay. The diagram. Okay. So direct income means facilities and services rendered without spending money. Indirect income, facilities and services rendered by extra efforts or by spending money. Is it clear? Okay. Then what do you mean by psychic income? The satisfaction achieved by spending money income and real income. By spending this money income and the real income, we get a satisfaction. That satisfaction is known as psychic income. It's very important. So first we learned about the importance of money. That's a general one. And then family income, right? Family income means we sum all the income or all the wages, all the salaries of all our family members and we join together. We sum this all wages, that is family income, not only the income from the father. Okay, Sana, not only from the father, we sum all the wages of our family members, that comes under the family income. Then we can classify this family income into three: real income, psychic income, and money income. Money income means the income that flows into our family just in the form of money, currency, checks, and all. We use the money to buy certain things, that is money income. Then real income, again classification, direct income and indirect income. Direct income means
without spending money,
like with our own interest or our own knowledge, we can teach our children. So we can save our money. We can collect the vegetables or we can collect the mango from our own garden. Rather than buying from a market, we can save the money. That is direct income. The real income. And then real indirect income, which means comes under the barter system and all, exchange of commodities. Okay, then psychic income, the satisfaction. It is a satisfaction that an individual or a person get by spending this money income and the real income. Is it clear? Okay, read. Take the page number 290. Sana, read the money income. Where is our Reina?
Money income is the purchasing power of the flow of money available over a given period of time. Money income is...
Okay, you can write this definition.
Money income is the money acquired by the family members after putting efforts. It can be earned in different ways like pay, wages, bonus, pension, interest, profit, gifts, rents, royalties, etc. Money earned in this manner may be used for purchasing and engaging services. Spending money income gives satisfaction. The frequency of flow of money income varies from a person. Spending money income gives satisfaction.
No. Satisfaction. Okay. Satisfaction, not satisfaction.
Like that word is not there?
I think no, right? Like that, satisfaction is a word like that. I don't know. Fine. Sana, continue.
The frequency of flow of money income varies from person to person. A person who is in...
Everyone's income is different.
A person who is in job gets regular income every month. A person having business of woolen garments earns more money during winter season.
So, a person... Or a person with a government job or a person with a permanent job, he or she can easily get the correct amount of money in every month or every year, right? But in the case of businessman and all, their money is not fixed. Sometimes it's very high, but sometimes it's very low. According to their business, according to their time and all, according to the season, their income is different. But all comes under this money income. Okay, the salary from everyone. Then Meghna, read the real income.
Real income is obtained from the efforts of family members or by spending money. Real income is a flow of commodities and services available for the satisfaction of human wants, needs, or a given period of time.
So if a question asks, what do you mean by this or the classification of family income, just write what is the definition of money income and write the definition of real income and then the definition of psychic income. Okay. No need of this real income, real direct income definition and real indirect income definition. Okay. Just give the examples for that. Read.
It includes all the goods, services and comforts of which can be obtained by either spending money or by the other means. Real income is of two types, real direct income, real indirect income. Real direct income. It includes those services and facilities which the family uses without spending money. In absence of those services and facilities, the family has to spend their money income. Sources of real direct income to a family are use of human resources.
If this real direct income is absent, the family need to use their money income, the salary, the wages. If a homemaker is or the homemaker has no knowledge about how to teach their children, then we need to provide other facility for their children, other educational facilities. So we need money for that, for arranging those facilities. Yeah, then.
Use of human resources. Ma'am, should I just read the heading?
Yes. Just the heading.
Services and facilities provided by the government. Judicious use of family assets.
Fine. The use of human resources, like what are the human resources? We already learned that time, our interests, our abilities, our skills, all these are the human resources. So use this human resources. Some use this human resources to save their money income. That's why this part comes under the real income. Okay. Then services and facilities provided by the government. The government provide the free education for the children or the free treatment for rural areas. The children belong to the rural areas. So it's also an additional bonus for them. Right. Then the judicious use of family assets. If you own a house, you can live in it and save money rather than renting a house. Right. If we rent a house, we need to give money for them every month. If we have our own house, we don't need money. That's our house. That's the difference. Simple topics. Then next one. Read, Asana, read. Read the real indirect income. Page number 291.
It includes all those services and facilities which we get by spending money in exchange of goods. Fringe benefits. If a person gets extra benefits from his place of work, it adds to his income. These come along with the salary, for example, free accommodation in addition to salary, free conveyance,
telephone facility, free education for children. In some hospitals, the staffs in their hospital, their children get free education. In some hospitals and all. In some institutions, some schools also provide free education for their students. Okay, then. The barter system, read that.
Exchange of a commodity or service also adds to income. Example, Hina needs...
Fine. Exchange of commodities or services also add to income. Okay. Exchange, the barter system means we exchange a service or we exchange any one of our good with other person. Then services of electricity, telephone, internet, etc. may be availed after paying money for this. Okay. Then Meghna, read the psychic income.
Psychic income. The satisfaction a person gets by spending money income and real income is called psychic income.
Is it clear? The satisfaction of a person by spending this money income and this real income, everyone get a satisfaction. That is called as psychic income. It's not in the form of money or it's not in the form of currency. Then psychic income consists of satisfaction which a person derives from his real income. Fine. Then here's the next paragraph. Psychic income is completely personal.
Psychic income is completely personal. It can differ for each individual and for each family because it depends upon their viewpoints and values. Each person gets different levels of satisfaction by using same goods under similar conditions. For example, a person may get total satisfaction by eating in a restaurant while another may not. It is difficult to estimate the level of satisfaction one gets by spending money, but judicious spending do help in increasing psychic income. It is clear from the above discussion.
Fine. So is it clear? Any doubts in money income, real income and psychic income? Fine. So let's move on to the next one. There are certain factors that affect our income in our family or income of a family. Some factors. What are the factors that affect the income? Sana, anyone? Any one point? The fact, don't look text. Just think and answer. Meghna?
Using of resources.
Very good. The use of human resources. We already discussed that. So that is the first factor, use of human resources. Use of human resources. Like if the family member use or a homemaker use their own knowledge, their own interest, their own ability, then they can easily increase the income. There is a possibility to increase the income by taking tuition and all with proper human resource like knowledge. Then proper use of time. It's another factor. Proper use of human resources, proper use of time. Sanas, please switch on the camera. Just the same example, a homemaker can easily take tuitions in her free time to increase their real income. So the homemaker use her time or the use his or her time to increase their money in, sorry, the real income. Okay, the use of time, the proper use of time, the proper use of human resources, then proper investment of money. It's very important. Investment of money. If this money or if our salary, our savings are kept in a bank, we will get an interest, right? The proper amount of money, if we put or deposit our money in a bank, we get an interest in every month or every year. That comes under the investment part. It's another factor. Proper investment of money. So proper use of human resources, use of time, the investment. And then commitment towards work. It's another factor. Commitment. Sana, add to this point. Commitment towards work. How this is, comes under a factor. Commitment. What do you mean by commitment? One can easily increase their production or their income with this commitment. If we are commit towards our work, we can easily finish our work without any fatigue, right? If you are committed towards your records and all, you can easily complete the record work on time, right? For an example, a businessman, if he is committed towards his work, he can increase their production. By the production, he can increase the income. Okay, then. That is a fourth factor. Then the last one, use of facilities provided by the government. Use of facilities provided by the societies and government. By this, one can improve the standard of living. For an example, the free education. We all have the free, as girls, we have the free education. Then for the government schools and all. Okay, free education, free food. Then there are lots of facilities that are provided by government. So there is no need to spend our money to buy books, our money to buy uniforms and all. It's all free for the government schools and all. So the wisely use of this government services also comes under as a factor that affect the income of a family. So these are the five important factors: proper investment of money, proper use of time, use of human resources, commitment towards work, use of facilities provided by society and government. Okay. Fine. So the proper use of time, if spare time is used to do some additional work, real income can be increased. For an example, in free time, a housewife can take tuitions. Then use of human resources. If family member use their resources like knowledge, interest, efficiency, skill, etc., then the increase in real income is possible. Then by using the facilities provided by society or government, family income can be increased. Then by proper investment, money can be increased. How you invest? What are the methods for investing? It's our next chapter. Do you know methods to invest money? In bank, in post office. These are the certain areas we deposit our money to improve our or increase our money. Okay, we get interest from that. Then commitment towards work. If a person does his work with interest, efficiency and commitment, he is assured to get positive results. Underline that. If a person gets his work with interest, if a person does his work with interest, efficiency and commitment, not only the commitment, but also the interest and efficiency is needed to get the positive result. Meghna, take the page number 289 and just read the points of importance of money. 289.
Importance of money. Most of our income is in the form of money.
Just read the points.
Money is used to exchange goods and services. It is a medium of exchange. In terms of money, the value of other commodities is determined. Money makes you self-dependent, which is a good feeling. If you have sufficient money, you can offer better life to your family. It helps to fulfill our basic needs and achieve our goals. It gives financial security. With money, you can help others in need. You can spend for charity. It serves as a yardstick to measure the standard of living of a family. It facilitates savings and investments that are used for capital formation.
Is there a certain importance of money? Okay. You can also write your own points. No problem. Okay. For this importance and then the techniques to cope up with stress and all, you can write your own points. No problem. Okay. So, Sana, what are the three types or three categories of family income?
Real income. Psychic income.
One more. What is this? The currency, banks and all. Money income. Okay. Money income, real income and psychic income. Okay. What are the two classifications of real income, Meghna?
Real direct income and real indirect income.
Good. Okay. A random question. Sana, give an example for the indirect income, real indirect income. Real indirect income. In real income, we have direct income and indirect income. Yeah. So, give an example for indirect income. Any one example.
Barter system.
Barter system. Very good. Give an example for direct income, Meghna.
Growing vegetables in the garden.
Good.